Hello guys, welcome back to Ray's Gaming Guitar Productions, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to route your OBS filter mic through a third-party application to be able to use it in games and in Discord. Now when I say OBS filtered mic, I am talking about a mic that you specifically tuned in OBS Studios, whether it's for streaming or recording. This mic should be the mic that you added lots of audio filters to make it sound clear and professional. Now, if you guys enjoyed these tutorials, please make sure to like and subscribe, and now let's get into it. Now, I said that it's a third-party application, but technically it's an audio driver that allows you to input audio and output in a different place. Now, the first thing you need to do is you need to go down in the description, and I provide you guys with a link to the website that will download these files, and the only files that you need to worry about is the setup.exe and the setup.x64.exe. Now, I would personally say just stick with the regular setup.exe. I don't know what's the point of the x64 version, but if you have an x64 PC like I do and you feel that maybe it'll help, you can download that one, but I'm pretty sure I downloaded the setup.exe version. Now, once you open that version and you go ahead and give it administrator permissions, then you just go ahead and you should see this. Now, all you need to do is just follow everything that it tells you to do, and it should, after all of it, it should say that you will need to restart your PC. Go ahead and restart your PC, and to make sure that it works, then you need to go ahead and go to your control panel, and you want to go to sound. Now, once sound comes up, then you want to make sure that it says cable input here, and in recording, it says cable output. Now, the way this will work is you want to go ahead and bring your OBS, and you want to go into settings, and then you want to go to audio, and then you want to go all the way down till you see advanced. Now, the way this will work is the monitoring device basically monitors what your mic is currently doing in OBS. And since we will be routing it through a driver into a output so that it's basically as another output, then it basically allows you to use your filtered mic in OBS that you filtered specifically for recording. You can use that crispy and professional mic inside of games, and a lot of people will like it. So all you need to do is you need to put in the monitoring device, you need to put cable input, and then in your game, you want to put cable output, and you can enable all these. I'm not sure what any of these do, but just to make sure that you have no problems, I would say just enable them, even if you don't know what they do, just like I don't know what they do. Now, once you go ahead and do that, then everything should be fine. As long as you see, like as you guys can see, the cable output is getting my mic right here. Now, one thing I've noticed is it's kind of delayed, but if you really think about it, let's say, for instance, you're playing Fortnite. To be honest, they would not know at all that it's delayed, and really, you won't know unless you can hear echo through their mics and you can hear that your mic is echoed. But to be honest, it's not really that serious as long as it's not like extremely delayed. But yeah, that's pretty much it. As long as you make sure that you put the cable input inside of the monitoring device and you put cable output inside of the recording device in either Discord or any of your games that are trying to access your mic, and as long as you see this working, you know that it's working in OBS, and as long as, of course, people can hear you in your games, you know that you successfully routed it, and now you will have a crispy and professional mic inside of your games.